Nancy Brinker's life was forged by a dark day in 1980 when she lost her beloved older sister. She made a promise to Susie, one that she plans to keep.
Nancy and Susie were inseparable, two sisters growing up in the small town of Peoria, Illinois.
There's not a day that goes by that I don't miss her. And even though it's been, you know, 30 years, life has never been the same.
When Susie was 33, she was diagnosed with breast cancer. Back then, no one talked about it and barely knew how to treat it.
In 1978, the times were extraordinarily different. There were no, there was no internet. There weren't even any 1-800 numbers to call. There were no patient support groups for young patients. There was really one cancer organization that people knew of, but there really wasn't a place to go share your breast cancer woes and talk to people, and particularly not in a smaller town.
After 3 years, 9 operations, and dozens of chemotherapy and radiation treatments, Susie lost her battle.
We were sitting in her living room, and she was very weak, and she looked at me, and she said, "You know, Nanny, someday when I get better, I want you to promise me that we're going to work to make sure that this doesn't happen to other families."
That conversation haunted and motivated Nancy. 2 years later, she formed the Susan G. Komen Foundation in honor of her big sister, Susie. The first Race for the Cure took place in Dallas a year later. But the heartache wasn't over. In 1984, Nancy was diagnosed with breast cancer.
I thought I would die. I actually was diagnosed with the same tumor Susie had.
Nancy went through an aggressive treatment and more than 10 surgeries. Her battle only fueled her desire to change the way other cancer patients were treated and to find a cure.
I am so grateful to be alive. I do believe I'm very spiritual, very religious. I believe I'm alive. I was given this gift of being alive to do this. I really believe it.
Through a global network of 125,000 volunteers, Komen has helped remove the old stigma about breast cancer, and it's created a comprehensive support system for survivors. Komen is now the largest funder of breast cancer research other than the U.S. government, to the tune of nearly $100 million a year.
When you feel down, when you feel down, when you feel lonely, when you feel afraid, there is nothing that will reboot you like turning off your computer in your head and reaching outside of yourself and helping someone else. Nothing. There's nothing else that can do that.
While Nancy's career has focused on Komen, she continues to wear many other hats, serving on advisory boards for Presidents Reagan, Clinton, and both Bushes.
Lajos Tihony, he was a deaf mute, and yet he was brilliant in his painting.
Brinker's home on Palm Beach is covered in Hungarian art. It's a carryover from when she served as